Welcome to the bridge course conducted by SSS Siddipet. This is Bhaskar Era, working as a mathematics teacher at Jilla Parishad High School, Singanaguda, Mulugu Mandal, Siddipet district. Today I am going to explain you about the coordinate geometry, 9th and 10th class standard. Subtopic is Cartesian plane and plotting a point on a graph. Learning outcomes. Students are able to learn Cartesian system of a plane. They can understand what are the rows and the columns, location of coordinates, plotting of coordinates on a graph, the connection between the geometry and algebra and with other branches of mathematics. Come on, let us begin. Look at the wall clock. Here is the wall clock. Can you say the location of wall clock? Providing with this information, can we say the exact location of a wall clock? No, it is not possible. Okay, so this is not enough to say the location of a wall. Okay, let us do one activity. Here I am taking a chessboard. We all know that how to play a chess, right? So here 8x8. Horizontal A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, vertical 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 numbers. Here I am taking a king and moving and placed here. What happens? Can you anybody tell the location of this king? We can say the location of this king is C2. Right. Now I am moving this king to another place and placing here. Now, what is the exact location of this king? Yes, E3. Now, again, I am moving this king to another box. Now, can you say, look at horizontal and vertical? Yes, it is on exactly G7. Right? I hope you understood. Now, coming to one more example. The minimum and maximum temperature of Hyderabad on a particular day in the month of June 2021 are minus 2 degrees Celsius and 12 degrees Celsius. How can we represent? Yes, by using number line, we can represent the temperature of a day. Right? So here I am taking number line. You know, number line having 0, right side positive integers and left side negative integers. Now, where is minus 2 degrees Celsius? Right here, left side of the 0 and right side 12 degrees Celsius. 12 is located here. So, like this, by using this scale, number line, this is the reference scale to the temperatures, right? So here we are using this number line as a reference scale to these temperatures. Okay.
Now let us understand what are the rows and what are the columns. The horizontal lines are called rows and the vertical lines are called columns. Look at the picture. Here it is horizontal arrow mark is there. So horizontal lines are called rows and vertical mark is there, they are the columns. So these are the rows and columns. Horizontal lines are called rows, vertical lines are called columns. You might have seen the ring games in exhibition. Here we will play a game arranged in rows and columns. Observe the following picture. Here is a peacock. So here is a peacock. See, where is the peacock? First row and fifth column. The position of peacock is 1, 5. Now the bird has come. Now the position of bird is second row and third column, 2, 3. Now one more picture is there. Monkey, third row and fourth column. The position of monkey is 3, 4. Okay. The representation of a point on a plane with idea of two references to development of new branch of mathematics known as coordinate geometry. René Descartes, a French mathematician, developed the study of coordinate geometry. Now we shall discuss about the point and also how to plot the point on a coordinate plane. Here is a Cartesian system. See, look at the picture. We have drawn the horizontal number line and the vertical number line. The intersecting two number lines called origin O, and the horizontal number line x prime is known as x axis and y dash is known as y axis. These two lines divided the plane into four parts. The first one is called quadrant 1, both x and y are positive, and quadrant 2 minus x y, and quadrant 3 is both are negative minus x minus y, and the quadrant 4 is x plus x and minus y. So the plane here is called Cartesian plane or coordinate plane, named after René Descartes. Okay students, now you understood what is the Cartesian system of a plane. Okay, right, let us move into another one. Let us try to locate the point 4, 2 on a graph, on a Cartesian system of a plane. Here is the graph, and horizontal line is called x-axis and vertical line is called y-axis. Now center intersecting point is O. Now I am giving the numbers to the lines 1, 2, 3, 4, left side negative numbers, upside positive and downside negative integers. Now we have to plot 4, 2. So the perpendicular to the x-axis 4 and y-axis is equal to 2. So see, the parallel line of x-axis is 2 to this, exactly equal to the 4. So now this is the point 4, 2. Here is the location of point 4, 2. X coordinate is called abscissa and y coordinate is called ordinate. So you remember the children, x is abscissa and y is ordinate. Now plot the following in the Cartesian plane: m 2, 4, a minus 5, -3, n 1, -4, b minus 2, 5. Here is the Cartesian plane, 4 quadrants, and first one 2, 4, see x axis 2, x and y coordinate 4. Here is the m 2, 4, the location of m 2, 4 is. Now a minus 5, 3, minus 5 is left side of the 0 and minus 5 and minus 3. Here it is a minus 5 and minus 3. Now n, see x 1 and y is minus 4, so it is n 1, -4. You observe the children, right? Next point b minus 2, 5, x axis x is minus 2 and y is 5. This is the point b minus 2, 5. So these are the points we have located on a graph, on a Cartesian plane. Okay students, now plotting a pair of points on graph sheet and join them by line segment. Now we have to plot and join the line segments, right? Here is the plane and you have to identify and locate 2, 4 and 4, 5. Here is a 2, 4, see. So how I am plotting, and it is 4, 5. Now these two points are located in the quadrant 1 only, because these all the coordinates are positive only. So these will come in the quadrant 1. Now I have joined by line segment. So now minus 1, -4, see it is both are negative, so it will be come in quadrant 3. So this is minus 3 and minus 5. Now I am going to join these two points with a line segment. Now this is the line segment of -1, -4 and -3, -5. So these are the line segments. Now coming to homework assignment, dear children, look at the graph, write the coordinates of points A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, right? Now second one, complete the below table based on the following graph. Here is the table I am giving beside the picture, and points, objects, coordinates, coordinates. So here some are missed. What are the missed? You have to write, then you will understand the concept. Now third one, in a graph sheet, plot each pair of points and join them by line segment. So students, you do this homework and show your subject teacher. Okay, thank you, good luck.